Hello everyone, welcome in LearnCHE. In this video, we are going to discuss about the very important topic with respect to chemical engineering and with respect to those engineers who are working in the production department in the any chemical industry, right? Whether they are working in a fertilizer plant, in a refinery, in power plant. So this topic, that is material balance or mass balance, we can say, is very important. Okay, so in this video we are going to discuss about the what is material balance, why is material balance, what is the importance of material balance in a chemical industry, and how to write the journal material balance. So I hope you will be learn a lot from this video. So if you are new here, so you can subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon. Okay, so let's start the video from what is material balance. So first we start from the definition of the material balance, right? So the definition of the material balance is here. You can see that material balance is an application of the conservation of mass, means it depends or it based on the conservation of mass. And the conservation of mass states that mass can neither be created nor destroyed. Got it my point? Suppose there is a reaction that is A plus B and it goes to C plus D. Then whatever will be the composition, and we can say the amount here. Suppose if there is a amount of these both is 100 kg, so here will be also 100 kg. Got it my point? Now ahead, which is used in the industry to analyze the physical systems. Okay, so this is very important, and we will see this via one example. It is used to analyze the physical systems. What is this means? We will discuss this via one example. Okay, so while you are solving the problems on the basis of material balance, so you should know that actually what you are doing, and if you are in the plant, so you should know that why we are using that material balance. Okay, if you know the why behind the whatever you are doing, so it is very important for you to do that work. Okay, and it will be enjoyable for you. Let's see here. This is my combustion chamber. Okay, there is my combustion chamber, and here I supply some feed. Okay, means you can simply say wood. Okay, I am supplying the wood. So wood consists of carbon, and we can say simply S. Okay, and here I'll get the residue. Okay, and in the residue there will be mainly S. Got it my point? And there will be some amount of carbon as well, so it will be in a minor amount. And what we supply here, we supply the air, and what we get the flue gases, or we can say the stack gases. Got it my point? So with the help of this material balance, we can find out the quantity, we can find out the composition, okay, of the residue here, or in the residue I can find out the what is the amount of S which is going to generate after the complete combustion. Okay, we can also find out the carbon quantity here if we know the feed. Suppose let the feed is 100 kg. Okay, so this is the beauty of the material balance. Just I am giving one example, and in our upcoming videos we will discuss about the physical systems. It may be unit operations like distillation, extraction, drying, crystallization, and we will also discuss with the with reaction like the combustion chamber. Okay, so I hope you understood that what is the beauty of this material balance. We can analyze our physical systems, we can analyze our system, that is our system, we can study that system, you can simply say, with respect to that material inflow and outflow. Okay, this is the first example. What is the second example? Okay, here you can see that I just erase this one. Okay, let's suppose this is my plant. Okay, and I can simply say this is my unit. Okay, and this is my equipment number 1, and this is my equipment number 9, means the last, and this is one is beginning, and I am supplying some raw material from here and getting the product from here. So with the help of material balance, you can analyze this entire unit. Okay, and you can also analyze the individual unit or individual equipment like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on. Got it my point? Means you can apply that material balance on the entire unit as well as on the each equipment. That is the beauty to analyze the our like equipment, or we can say to analyze equipment means process. Okay, like distillation, if suppose there is a distillation column, so we can apply the material balance on the distillation column. Okay, if there is an extraction unit, so we can apply the material balance on the extraction unit. Got it my point? Means I want to connect you with the industry as well as with the book. I hope you understood that what is the material balance, and I hope you have now the rough idea what we do with the material balance in the industry as well as in our like in our chemical engineering. Okay, now let's see that why is material balance. Okay, why means why we are using this material balance. So by using the material balance, or you can simply say the heat and material balance, we may analyze our physical system or unit. Okay, like you can analyze the distillation column. Okay, you can analyze the extraction unit, you can analyze the dryer, you can analyze the crystallizer, etc. Got it my point? Analyze means simply you are doing the study with respect to material inflow and outflow. Second, like you can also count the material stream entering, or you can say the inflow, and the material stream leaving, or you can say the outflow. And you can calculate that unknown quantity. Okay, suppose here there was the combustion chamber, I was feeding feed F and I was getting residue. Okay, in that residue, how much amount of S is there, or how much amount of carbon present there? We can find out it with the help of this material balance. Okay, so this is the beauty of the material balance. Okay, I hope now you got that why we are using this material balance. Here I am using the combustion chamber. You can also analyze here, or you can also take the one example from the distillation column. Okay, like in the distillation column, first we feed, that is F. Suppose there is a binary mixture A plus B. Okay, and from here you are getting the overhead product, and from the bottom you are getting the residue, or I can say the bottom product. So same we can do with the distillation column with the help of material balance. You can find the unknown quantity. Got it? Now let's see that what is the importance of it. If you have understood that two slides, so it will be very very important, or it will be very easy for you to understand. Okay, so the first importance of the material balance is that we may track the our material inflow and outflow through this heat and material balance. Got it my point? Then it helps us in the project phases. Okay, like suppose if we have to make one unit of the urea plant. Okay, so while making that project, this heat and material balance help us there. Heat and material balance help us there to prepare the PNID. Okay, like after the process simulation, we make the PFD, and then we do the heat and material balance. Okay, and after that PFD and heat and material balance, we prepare the equipment process data sheet, and after that we prepare the PNID. So we can say that it helps us in the project phase. Got it? And in the finally, you can simply say that, like if you are working in a industry, so we can say that it helps us to track the production. Okay, like it may be production of urea, production of ammonia, production of naphtha, like production of any product, whatever, like in which industry you are working. So on the daily basis, monthly basis, you can check on the yearly basis as well as versus budget, like what was your budget and how and where you are. Okay, you can do that very easily with the help of material balance. Okay, now we will see that how to write the journal material balance. Okay, this is very very important. If you learn it, so you will be easily solve any problem. Okay, if there will be some term and condition, you will be easily solve that problem. First let's go through the little bit theory. Okay, the first thing is there are two types of material balance. The first one is a steady state material balance. Okay, where the accumulation term will be zero, and in the unsteady state there is accumulation is not zero, okay, in the case of unsteady state, because in the unsteady state your variables are going to change with the time, but in steady state your variables are not going to change with the time, okay. So first we will discuss or we will go ahead with respect to steady state, but in the practice we deal with the unsteady state, okay. So let's go ahead with the steady state. And at the steady state there are two type of material balance. The first material balance we will discuss with respect to material balance of a component, means we can apply the material balance on a component. As we discussed that in our previous example in the combustion, that we can apply the material balance on the carbon and we can also apply the material balance on the S, okay, and we can also apply the material balance on the total system, okay. So that's why here total material balance on system. Suppose it was my distillation column, so it was F, it was D and it was B. So the total material balance will be F is equal to D plus B. Got the point? Now it is also further classified, and the classification is like that: material balance of a component with reaction, material balance of a component without reaction, and material balance of component with inert reaction. Mainly this inert reaction comes under the without reaction, but we are considering here in a separate subgroup, no problem. And here the total material balance, it also classified in two subgroup, that is with reaction, total material balance with reaction, and total material balance on the system without reaction. I hope you do not have any doubt, okay, till now. If you have any doubt, you can let me in the comments box. I'll give you the reply as soon as possible. And if you are enjoying this video, you can also subscribe our YouTube channel, okay. So now we will see that how to write the material balance, okay. I hope you have understood that what is the material balance of a component, what is the material balance, or what is the total material balance. See here, this is our general material balance, okay. If you will understand this general material balance, then you will be easily solve any problem. Okay, if suppose in the problem there will be some condition, you will be easily solve that problem. There is no any issue. Okay, so the main formula or the general formula, okay, if there is any, we can say the concept. So for that concept, there is one general concept, okay, and we can say the general formula, okay, and after that the conditions apply. So this is our general formula, okay, and according to that general formula or the general material balance, there is an equation is in minus out plus generation minus consumption is equal to accumulation. You can relate with this distillation column, okay. You can also take any other unit operation, no problem, okay. Now if we see that, so it will be rate of mass into the system, okay, rate of mass into the system minus rate of mass out of the system, means rate of mass into the system minus rate of mass out of the system. This is our system, that is distillation column, plus rate of generation of mass within the system, okay, minus rate of consumption of mass, okay. While in the unit operation there will not be any reaction, but this is a general formula, okay. While doing the problem, these terms will be cancelled out or become zero, so that's the another thing, but this is our general formula, okay. And here is the, and in the last, equal to rate of accumulation of mass within the system, means what is the general formula? The general formula is rate of mass into the system, okay, rate of mass into the system, rate of mass out of the system. Like rate means kg per r, okay, kg per r, rate of generation of mass within the system, okay, rate of generation of mass within this system, rate of consumption of mass within this system, like how much amount of mass of the system, like mass of the product is going to consume within this system, is equal to rate of accumulation of mass within this system, how much amount of mass is accumulated within this system. This is the general material balance. Now on the basis of our like our problem, we can modify or we can arrange this equation. Okay, suppose if you have to write the material balance on steady state overall mass balance, then this material balance will be changed. What will be changed? This will be zero, this will be zero, and this will be zero. Why? Because it is a total material balance with respect to steady state, or in the steady state, as I have already told you, accumulation will be zero, and in the steady state the consumption and generation will be also zero. Okay, got it my point? Same thing, that we can also apply the material balance on steady state, overall material balance with reaction. Okay, then we can also apply the material balance on the inerts, and we can also apply the material balance on the total system. Got it my point, what I want to tell you? Okay, so this is the just a general overview of the material balance. Okay, and in our upcoming video, in our next video, we will apply the material balance on a specific problem, like steady state overall material balance with reaction, without reaction, then like steady state overall material balance with reaction, steady state component mass balance for a component which is like taking a part in a chemical reaction, then steady state component mass balance for a non-reacting substance. Okay, in the next video or in our subsequent videos, we are going to discuss about it. Okay, you will enjoy this entire playlist. Okay, so that was about the material balance. If you have any doubt, in this video, you can let me in the comments box. I'll give you the reply as soon as possible. You can also express your doubts in the comments box if you have any doubts. If you have any doubts in any concept in process calculation and in chemical engineering subjects, you can also let me in the comments box. I'll make the videos on that particular topic. So thank you for watching. See you soon.